Hey everyone, it's Kristen from K-Becca, and today I'll be testing out the foil quill on some different surfaces, including acetate, Duralar, vellum paper, and wood veneer sheets. I'll be using the foil quill brand foil for these tests, and we'll test both the fine tip and standard tip sizes in this video. I'm testing with exactly the same designs that I've been using in my testing so far in order to keep things consistent, though I did run out of the foil quill gold foil that I've been using for testing, so this time around I'll be using the foil quill rose gold foil for the fine tip testing and the silver foil for the standard tip testing. For all of these results, I used a speed of 10, a force of 22, and a single pass in the Silhouette Studio settings, so a little bit more force than the default sketch settings. For each surface that I tested, I cut a piece of foil large enough to cover the surface, then taped it on all four sides with the foil quill placement tape. The foil quill should be allowed to heat up for at least 5 minutes for best results, and after mine was heated and ready to go, I loaded the mat into the Silhouette Cameo and sent the files to the machine for foiling. I won't make you sit through the foiling process, so let's skip ahead to the results. First up are the results with the fine tip foil quill. I'll hold a piece of black cardstock against the back of the clear acetate here so you can see things better. And the results with the fine tip on the single line designs are pretty great. There are a few areas where the foil coverage looks just slightly less solid, but you have to look really close to see. And holding the acetate in an angle makes the design a lot easier to see. This surface is less forgiving though with the filled design. You can definitely see a lot of areas where the foil coverage is spotty, so it has kind of a weathered look. But on the single line designs, the results are great. Next up is Duralar, which is an acetate alternative. I love using it to cut stencils, and you can get fantastic results with it using the laser printer and heat laminator foiling technique too, so it's a very versatile material and also a lot smoother than any of the vellum papers that I've come across so far. The results with the fine tip on the Duralar are pretty darn awesome on the single line designs. The lines are crisp and solid, and it's easier to see the designs straight on with this material than it was on the acetate too. The results on the filled design definitely look more solid than on the acetate, but you can still see some areas where the foil coverage is spotty. This is on par with most of the foils that I've tested on cardstock too. Decent results, but not fantastic. But the single line design results are excellent. Up next is the Basil vellum paper, and this has a noticeably rougher and more textured feel than the Duralar. The results with the fine tip on the single line designs are very good. I want to say that the texture on the paper actually gives a bit of a textured look to the results, but the lines are still very solid and pretty crisp looking. When you hold the paper at an angle though, the foil has more of a textured shine to it as opposed to the more solid shine on the acetate and Duralar. The results are also pretty good on the filled shape. As with the other surfaces, the fill does have some areas where the foil coverage is kind of spotty, but overall I think these results look a little bit more solid than on the other two surfaces that we've tested so far. Next, I tested some lighter weight colored vellum that I've had in my stash for a while, and this particular vellum paper is a little smoother than the Basil vellum that I just tested. It's also noticeably thinner. The results on the single line designs are very good, very solid and crisp lines, though just like the Basil vellum, I think the texture on the paper does give a little bit of a textured appearance to the results. The filled design also looks pretty good. There are some spotty, weathered looking areas just like on the other vellum, but overall not too bad. I also tested some of the Silhouette adhesive wood sheets, and I'll share the results with those with both the fine tip and standard tip toward the end of the video. Next up are the results with the standard tip foil quill. I ran out of the rose gold foil, so I had to use the silver foil for these, and I do want to say that the silver foil does show up better on a number of these surfaces, more so for the color of the foil, I think, than because of the results. But I'm also pleased with the results, so let's have a look. First up is the acetate, and again, I'll hold up a piece of black cardstock against the back so you can get a better look. The standard tip size does give the single line designs a slightly bolder look than with the fine tip, but you can see a few small areas where the foil didn't adhere. Overall, the results are pretty solid though. For the filled design, the standard tip does look a little bit more solid than the design on acetate with the fine tip, but you can still see the lines where the tip sketched, just like with the other tip. Up next is the Duralar, and just like with the fine tip, the results with the standard tip are fantastic. The foil coverage in the single line designs is pretty darn solid, with just very small areas where the foil didn't adhere. So not quite as good as with the fine tip, but still great. The larger tip also gives the filled design a more solid look with just some small areas of spotty coverage here and there. Next is the Basil Vellum paper, and the single line designs are comparable to the same designs with the fine tip on this paper. The texture on the paper gives the designs a little bit of a textured look, especially at an angle, and I do think that they look just slightly weathered with the standard tip, not quite as solid as with the fine tip. On the other hand, the filled design has a more solid look than with the fine tip. I think the larger tip helps blend those sketch lines for a more solid appearance, but there are still some areas where the foil didn't adhere completely. Results on the lighter weight colored vellum are great, especially the single line designs. The foil coverage maybe isn't quite as solid as with the fine tip, but it could just be that the texture on the paper gives a slightly textured look to the design. The filled design also looks pretty darn good, with just some weathered looking areas here and there. Finally, here are the results on the Silhouette adhesive wood sheets. These sheets are only 5x7 inches, so I wasn't able to fit all of the designs on them, but I wanted to test the most intricate design to see how it did, and I'm pleasantly surprised by how great these results are. The fine tip results look a little more subtle, but I think that's more about the foil color, because the silver foil with the standard tip stands out better against the dark wood. I did foil with the grain, so any lines that fall right on the grain line can look a little bit more textured, but the lines are very solidly foiled with both the fine tip on the top design and the standard tip on the bottom design. Just like with the cardstock and other surfaces that I've tested with the standard tip, there do tend to be some areas with foil coverage that's a bit spotty, but you have to look closely to spot those areas. I did accidentally place a piece of tape over the very top area of the bottom design, the one done with the standard tip, which is why you might notice that those areas aren't foiled. So that was completely user error, not the fault of the foil quill. Overall, I'm really happy with the results for both the fine tip and standard tip foil quill on all of the different surfaces. The results were pretty solid across the board. The vellum papers did add a bit of a textured look to the single line designs, especially, but the foil coverage was still very solid. Being able to foil on all of these different surfaces opens up so many creative options for card making, paper crafting, and more. I'll also have photos of all of the test results over on my blog, and the link to that is in the description area below the video if you're watching on YouTube. You can also find a full list of supplies used in this video in the description area below, or in the area below the video if you're watching on kbecca.com. I hope that this video has been helpful for you, and if it has, I'd really appreciate it if you'd give the video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I hope you'll tune in again soon.